Hello students, welcome back. I am Anamika, your bio teacher, and today I will continue the same chapter, crop production and management. And today's topic is methods of weeding. As I have earlier discussed in the previous video about the weeds. Weeds, that means unwanted plants which are grown along with the crop plants, which take the nutrients from the soil. That means they compete with the crop plants for the nutrients, sunlight, air, water. So in this way, they hamper the crop plants, which affect the production. So that's why it is necessary to remove the weeds, and that process is called weeding. So what are the different methods of weeding? First is removal of weeds by using hands. By using hands also, farmers remove the weeds, but it can be not used on a large scale. So that means in a large field, it is not possible for farmers to use the removed by using hands. Removal of weeds by using trowel. I think you are familiar about the term khurpi. So that is trowel, that is the agriculture implement, which is also used for removing the weeds, that means unwanted plants. Next is biological methods. Nowadays, scientists are trying to find the natural or biological ways of controlling the weeds, plant pests and diseases. Why? Because the chemicals that are harmful, like weedicides or other the pesticides, insecticides, it affect the living organisms. Sometimes it may affect the soil also. It also kill the useful microbes. So they are finding the natural way. One way is to use the natural enemies of the weeds and pests to kill them. And another way is to develop the disease resistant varieties of the crops so that it is not prone to certain diseases. Next is by using weedicides. Weedicides, that means the chemicals which are used for killing the weeds. Some examples are 2,4-D, MCPA. So these are the examples of weedicides. So what are weedicides? Right now I told you, harmful chemicals that are used for killing the weeds, that is called weedicide. Next is protecting crops from pests and diseases. What do you mean by pest? Pest, that means the animals or the insects which may harm the crop. So that's why it is necessary to remove the pest by using the different chemicals, and that chemicals are called pesticides. Pesticides are of various types. Insecticides, fungicides, so these are the rodenticides. These are the different examples of pesticides. And some microbes also, that means the various types of the microorganisms, if they affect the crops which are not, that means if the seeds are not disease resistant, having the capacity of disease resistance, so that in that case they may prone to the certain diseases which is happen in the plant. So that's why it is necessary to protect the crops from being destroyed and contaminated. So different chemicals that is used for these purposes are insecticides, pesticides, rodenticides. Some examples are BHC. BHC, that is benzene hexachloride, or it is also known as gamexine. Next is DDT. DDT, that is dichloro, diphenyl, trichloroethane, malathion. So these are the different examples of the pesticides, insecticides, etc. Now the next topic is, what are the disadvantages of using the weedicides, pesticides and insecticides? Some points are given here. They are highly poisonous and they pollute the water, air and soil. Sometimes they may kill the useful microorganisms that is present in the soil. So if we, that means, use the these chemicals in large amount or in excess amount, then what may happen? It is easily soluble. So due to water runoff, it may go through the water bodies and it will affect the aquatic organisms. It also pollute the water. It contaminate the air and soil too. Sometimes it may kill the useful microorganisms which helps in the decomposition process, which are present in the soil. These chemicals, sometimes they are accumulate inside the body of the human by the food chain. And what will be happen? It may affect the various body parts. Sometimes it may cause the cancer also. and this process is called biomagnification, biological magnification, or bioaccumulation. What is the this means? That means accumulation of the harmful chemicals inside the body of the living organisms. So that process is called biological magnification or bioaccumulation, which you will read about in the next class. Apart from this, certain precautions, that means farmers have to taken while spraying the weedicides or the other chemicals. So what are the certain precautions? First, these chemicals should be diluted. That means these are not used in the concentrated amount. I think you have read about that concentrated in class 7. One chapter is there, acid and base. I think you may familiar about the term concentrated acid, dilute acid. Dilute, that means we have to add water in these chemicals. And then you have the farmers have to use that chemicals. And while spraying the weedicides, the person have to cover his mouth, nose, so that these harmful chemicals, they will not enter inside the body. And these chemicals may spread in the field before flowering in the crop plants. So these are the certain precautions which farmers have to take before spraying the weedicides or the other chemicals like insecticides, pesticides. Next topic is harvesting. What do you mean by harvesting? Harvesting, that means the process of cutting and gathering of the mature crops. That is called harvesting. The traditional implement used for harvesting the crop is the sickle. Thank you, student.